What's going on, guys? Boys, we are back with some more UFC. This guy can give me some trouble. You're blessed, I chose you. There, I need to keep this thing in the stand up. If I can keep this fight in the stand up, then I'm gonna do just fine though.
This round, I just want to see heavy punches. Let it go. Beautiful combination. Keep it up. Put the pressure on him. Man, your next opponent is going to be no match for you. Oh, wow. Wow, yes. That punch damaged him. Yes. Let's go.
Yeah, and I'm gonna ask, I actually like him. I actually like the guy who's fighting out this week.
Okay, heavy bag and heavy punches. You ready? That's how we work. This is when we put them all together. Great job. That's the aggression I want to see in your next fight. Great job. Let's go. 30 on the clock. There we go. That's how we do it.
Yeah, you're definitely just like hitting the bags is.
Today we're really gonna tighten it up. Here we go. Sequence of strikes there. Here we go.
get back here. I'm not poking around.
Man, your next opponent is gonna be no match for you. Nice kick. That's a nice one. He felt that one.
Yo, he flew. He said,
all right,
I believe.
30 seconds left.
Yep, we're gonna strengthen that leg. I'm gonna put in the hype of the fight.
Some leather today. I'll call it out, you throw. Man, your next opponent is gonna be no match for you. Man, your next opponent is gonna be no match for you. Let's go! Don't stop now, you got 30 seconds.
Yeah, well, I think I'm probably gonna hit the bags again.
Some leather today. I'll call it out, you throw. Got 30. Let's go. Don't worry about it. That's why it's called...
Let's go.
All right, coming up next, the wait is over. We get to this matchup for the UFC welterweight division title. All right, so here he is, the number one welterweight contender, getting set to challenge for the UFC's 170-pound title. Took a long winning streak in many years for him to realize this opportunity. He is not taking it lightly. He has said all here during fight week he's appreciative of this opportunity, but he is confident he is going to maximize it and leave as not just a contender, but a UFC champion. He is the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC welterweight champion in a division full of killers. He has remained the hunted at 170 pounds. Now, unquestionably staring at his toughest challenger to date, can he go back home as the champion? If he can, another chapter to one of the greatest welterweight legacies the Octagon has ever seen. Our tale of the tape for this, our main event of the evening.
Here we go.
So more than 15 years, the gap in age between these two fighters, and they both possess a similar height and reach. All right, now for the particulars, we go inside the Octagon to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Dan Mergliotta. This is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Bell Center in Montreal, Quebec, Canada. It's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC welterweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a wrestler holding a professional record of 24 wins, 3 losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Boca Raton, Florida, presenting the challenger, Kamaru, the Nigerian Nightmare, Usman.
And now,
introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a boxer, holding a professional record of 14 wins, no losses. He stands 6'1" tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of New York, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending UFC welterweight champion of the world, Gomez.
This is for the UFC championship. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. I want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out fighting.
Oh!
So here we go with round one of this UFC welterweight championship fight. All eyes on the champion as he looks to defend the title yet again. Prior to his title reign, we saw this 170-pound title change hands quite a bit. Not so since he earned the strap. We'll see if he can keep it here tonight against the number one contender. Got the single collar tie. And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if there's more where that came from.
Boxing.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
He's gonna try to take him down. There you go.
Oh, shit.
Wow. Slams him to the canvas with authority. How about the speed on that reversal there? I mean, I know you can get out of some bad spots, but not with that type of speed.
You cannot allow him to get leverage on the bottom. What a sweep. There's no give on that leg kick.
And now he's got that tie clinch. We'll see what he can do with it.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
And he landed the right hand there. Hey, finally gets the takedown. It wasn't for any lack of effort, but finally that shot was good enough to get his opponent down.
I don't know how many times, John, I could have watched this guy shoot takedown attempts without securing one. It's almost like out of pity, you feel good for him to finally get it done. Now what does he do with this top control?
I need you to move, okay? Scramble. Oh, big combination of ground and pound strikes here, DC. This could be the beginning of the end.
I mean, you gotta be very careful when you take these big ground and pound strikes. You need a controlled posture on the bottom, and if you're the top guy, the guy that's looking to finish, continue to gain posture and rain down big strikes on your opponent.
There on the ground.
Unbelievable position change. Wow, what a transition.
Under a minute to go in round one. That is his biggest strike as he has landed thus far.
Ooh.
Big, massive shot lands. Look at how tough his opponent is, though. Still standing, still in there.
My stuff on my shit.
30 seconds remain in the round. Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. 5 minutes in the books. All right, so there's the horn. He got knocked down by a punch in that round, but he is able to survive. We'll see if they can make some adjustments.
He's as tough as they come. He took that shot and he kept plodding forward. He got off.
From his cheek now. Kick to the body by Usman.
What a punch.
All right, he engages in the single collar tie. Well, he has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string anything together in terms of solid combinations.
It's because he's not committing to it fully. He throws his jab. He may blow the right hand out there, but he's not really sitting down on the right hand.
All right, so a high amplitude double leg takedown there. Now we'll see what he can do with it to try to advance position on the ground.
You knew that he was going to attack the double because he's such an explosive guy. He got it on the hips, finished the shot very quickly. Fantastic job.
Well, Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining. He loaded up there on that high kick.
Oh! Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Oh, can't do that in soccer, but it's allowed here. Nice trip to get the takedown.
Oh, great foot sweep right there. Got to the clinch, started manipulating the body, and the moment his opponent took a misstep, boom, tripped him right over the top. Great job.
All right, so the strike lands, but my children hit hard.
Yeah, at this point, early in the fight, you saw his opponent's head snapping back. You can see the effect the punches were taking. Now, he may as well just smack him in the arm like, good job, guys.
So 33 total strikes have landed for Kamaru Usman. Landing at a 50. So another takedown here by Kamaru Usman. Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice. Well, a really good second round for him thus far after a somewhat lackluster. Oh, shit. Now his opponent's really on the ropes.
His opponent's on beat streak. He's hurt so bad. I don't know what he's going to do to stay in this fight.
Power on display from Kamaru Usman as he lands yet again there.
Kamaru Usman showed in the Colby Covington fight, not only is he the best welterweight in the world, he may just be the toughest.
There as he lands, and maybe time to get the bonus checks ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got him hurt very bad with his head kick. Now he has to find one more strike to end the night.
That is a huge shot right there, DC. He don't need too many more of those.
No. Looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
All right, so now we are on the ground. Now he is in his wheelhouse. We'll see if he can get one of his submissions to pop here or not.
Now he's chasing the triangle.
And this could be trouble here. Oh, and there's the horn at the end of the round. How about this fight, folks? You see, he was nearly caught in a submission there right at the end of the round, saved by the bell. So back to the stool, mentally probably not in a great place here. We'll see if he can recover and get himself back into this fight. All right, so let us now check out some of the action in that round, DC. There was a whole lot of it, including a stunner upstairs that nearly closed the show.
It was a...
You ready?
All right, here we go with this third round of this championship fight. Straight right hand, no good. Single collar tie here.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one? And this dude's cashing chips. Look at how he turns his hip into that leg
kick. Both fighters exchange in the pocket here. Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? Ooh. Oh, a little single collar tie there.
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
His opponent in a world of trouble.
Such a sneaky head kick. He did not recognize him. He was sitting high, and now he's got him hurt bad.
Splits the guard, lands the right hand. Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue.
Look at him dig that body shot right up through his opponent's throat.
Both fighters hanging down in the pocket and both landing. Right, so once more, he takes the fight to the ground. That was his game plan, exactly what he planned on doing coming into the fight. So far, so good.
So far, so good. There's no reason to be disappointed.
Oh!
Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Oh, he might be out. The way he drew it up as he gets the knockout victory here tonight, it's hard to land a strike more flush than he did right there.
And the best
I'm not even
sure
the opponent saw it coming. So he'll see the replay and probably shake his head. But ultimately, this is a huge result and a huge win for that fighter here tonight. So there he is, the undisputed UFC welterweight champion. What a finish he turned in here tonight as he gets it done by way of knockout.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mugliotta is going to stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 11 seconds of round number 3. Declaring the winner by knockout, and still the undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world, Gomez.
So the celebration is officially on after a successful UFC welterweight title defense here tonight. He will go out the same way he came in as the undisputed UFC welterweight champion. He is your winner by knockout. And what a way to send a statement to the rest of the contenders in this division that it is going to take a monumental effort to dethrone this 170-pound king.
I think I showed improvement in the ground game. That kick is deadly, though. Getting harder. Who the fuck is this guy?
Sweet science. Let's go. Yeah. Yes, big punch. Yeah, that'll leave a bruise. That's it. Come on. Excellent blocking.
Punch.
You got 30. Oh, nice punch. Nice punch. He felt that one. Hey, now we know what we have to work on, right? Don't worry about it. We'll get better.
That's not good. Yeah, yo, I have to miss. No way.
Just power on the bag now. Listen to my call-outs. Man, your next opponent is gonna be no match for you. Come on now, you got 30.
Yeah, yo, I know sometimes in the training it does not come out as.
Good work, kid. Let's keep hitting.
I noticed that sometimes in the training it does not come out as. Keep hitting them
okay.
Bags, bro.
Heavy bag and heavy punches. You ready? Your next opponent is gonna be no match for you. Your next opponent is going to be no match for you. All right, 30 seconds left. Really impressed with your performance today. Great job. Nice, nice.
ready? I want to see good technique and form this round. Nice work!
What the hell?
Beautiful combination. Keep it up. Put the pressure on him.
Oh.
Man, your next opponent is gonna be no match for you.
I don't know how that knife. Massage. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I have the reach advantage too, so.
All right, coming up next, the wait is over. We get to this matchup for the UFC welterweight division title. So without further delay, here we go. Round one is underway. This is the UFC welterweight championship, and there is the champion out of the red corner working his way to the center of the octagon. He has defended this belt in the past and believes if he can do so again tonight, and here and still, he could go down as one of the greatest 170-pound fighters in UFC history. In order to do just that, he has said, I've got to get off to a good start here tonight. We'll see if he attacks offensively here. You saw the tail of the tape. He has a reach advantage and made good use of it there with that punch. Good series of punches by him there. He has...
Oh! What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight.
Oh! Oh, he connects with another uppercut. He's landed a few big ones so far here.
That is his best punch. He finds it from so many different positions, and he can find...
Oh!
He's getting lit up right now, John.
He's got him here.
That one is going to end the fight.
Yep. Just over 3 minutes to go in our first round. Oh!
Look at the turnover in that kick.
Both guys landing with conviction now. How about that shin? Really timing his shots nicely. Good tempo, very accurate, finding.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Back to the feet.
That one is going to end the fight.
Yep.
Actually got
under 2 minutes now to go in the round.
Real nice body kick.
Down he goes. I got him with the kick. He landed 17 strikes. Now, I think I helped a little bit with that. Just by, like, not letting him breathe. Like, never, like, let him, like, get into, like, a full-on, like, rhythm. Yes, who's our next fight gonna be? Nick Diaz is hanging up the gloves and walking away from. So we're gonna be against Paulo Costa. Yeah. Anyway, that'll do it for this episode. Hope you all enjoyed. Have a good one, and I'm out. Bye.